I've made a copy of ODB 38, and I'm calling this one ODB 39, Normalizing, Part 3. I've deleted all the queries in this database, and most of the forms. I'm leaving this one in case we need to refer to it in a future tutorial. I also updated the employee ID in our employees table. I changed the end date from 1899 to 1999. I will put both the before and the after out on the website in case any of you want to download the databases and work along with me. In the last two videos, we created a new group table and an employee department table, and we added some constraints to the department table. In this video, we're going to update our employee table to point to the group table and the department table, as well as add some constraints to the employee table to only allow groups that are on the group table and departments that are on the department table. Before I create the new table, I want to make a copy of the original employees table. So I'm going to right-click, rename, and we're going to change this to Table Employees Original. Now let's create the new employee table. I've got a query to create our new employee table. It's very similar to what we've already seen. We've got the drop table, which will delete the table if it exists, and it doesn't because we renamed the old version. Then we're going to create our new table employees. Inside the parentheses, we've got our employee ID. We've seen this as a primary key, not null. Last name, not null. Gender, start date, end date. All these look pretty similar to what we have until we get down to department ID. This is replacing department. It's now going to be the department ID, which is an integer, and we're going to set a default value of 0. So if nothing's entered in, it will default in a 0. The same for group ID. Then we've got our hourly wage and employee picks. Those will be the same that we already have. Now we've got our constraints. We've seen constraint in our previous videos. This first one starts off with constraint, then my variable name, and I'm calling this CK for check, GNDR for gender, then the type of constraint. In this case, it's a check constraint, and it's going to check to make sure gender only allows in the values of male and female. We can also have nulls because we did not make this field not null. So it'll be a null, a male, or female. The important thing to note about this is we cannot create this type of constraint in the LibreOffice GUI. It has to be done with a query. Our next constraint, I'm giving this the variable name, check start end date. It's a check constraint, and it will make sure that the end date is greater than the start date. And now you know how I found the employee ID number 3 being 1899 had to be updated to 1999. These last two constraints are similar to what we've already seen. I've got my variable name. These are a foreign key constraint on department ID and the group ID. They're referencing the other table. For department, references the department table, department ID. For the group, references the group table and the group ID. But this very last line, this one's new. We've seen this when we were in the relationships window. We're saying on delete, set default. If we delete that department record, the value for our department ID will default to 0, which for department was unassigned, and for group ID unknown. And this last part, on update cascade, means if we change this department or group ID, it will automatically change our department and group ID. So let's select all, copy, and create the table. Going into SQL, paste, and execute. To see our table, I need to go into View, Refresh Tables, and here's our new employee table. That looks good, but now we need some data. To get some data, I've got another query. We've already seen queries like this. We're going to insert into our table employees, and we've got all the fields listed, and we're going to do that from a select, and that select is going to be from our table employees original. Most of the fields are just going to be moving things over. We've got employee ID, last name, first name, all the way down until we get to our department. Now we need to change this department from the department name to a department ID. We're going to do that with the case statement. We're saying case when department equals accounting, change that value to 1. If it's not accounting, we're going to do another case. And it checks case when department equals IT, assign the value 2. If it's management, assign a 3. If it's marketing, assign a 4. If it's security, assign a 5. If it's manufacturing, assign a 6. And if it's none of those, put in a 0. And 0 was unassigned for our department. Then we've got all our right parentheses until we get down to our next case statement. And the next one's going to be for the group, which does the same thing. If it's group A, assign a 1, group B a 2, and if it's not found, assign a 0. Then we've got our hourly wage and employee picks, which are the same on both tables. Let's select all using Control A, copy, tools, SQL, paste, and execute. Let's open up that table and see if it worked. There's all our data. And now instead of the department names, we've got department ID and group ID. Now we've got all our data on the tables the way we want. Let's go into our relationships and check those out. Tools, relationships. Here we see all the relationships we have right now. Here's our new employee table. And here's our original employee table. We'll want to move these relationships over to our new table, but let's look at what we have. On our new table, we just created these two relationships. So let's edit this and check it out. We have from our table employees department ID to our table department ID. We've got update cascade and set to default. These are the two that we just assigned with that SQL. The next thing we want to look at is we want our employee phone number table to be connected to our new employee table and not with our employee's original. So I'm going to click on the line, right click, and delete this relationship. Then I'm going to grab the employee ID and place it onto this employee ID just like we had it. And I want to edit the relationship. This is one we did earlier. We want to update cascade and delete cascade. This other relationship is when we created our department table, we wanted our department contact person to be on the employee table. We've created a new employee table, so we no longer want this constraint. We're going to edit just to see what we had. We have update cascade and set to null. Let's delete this. And now I'm going to set this to our new employee table. So I'm going to click on contact person, and we want this to be on our employee table. It's asking us, this relation exists. Do you want to edit the current one or create a new one? We want to create a new relationship. So we have two going from our department table to our employee table. And we want to have it from employee ID on our employee table to our department contact person on our department table. We want to update cascade if it's updated, and if it's deleted, we want to set to null. Now we've got all our relationships transferred over to our new employee table. We're going to keep this old one out there just a little longer in case we need it. I'm going to save the relationships. and save the database.